topic is how to ensure security of a service that has a multi-million audience. We're going to have four great speakers. Denis Kuvshinov, a representative of Positive Technologies, head of Cyber Threats Analysis. Hi, hi. Please take your seat.
Илья Борисов, директор.
Next up, Илья Борисов, head of methodology,
ВК,
information,
Илья,
security with VK.
Hi,
we will be discussing a new social media.
Игорь Залевский,
to launch jointly with Маяковский.
Ростелеком.
Игорь, head
привет,
of ДСОК, SOC with Ростелеком Solar, Игорь Овчинников,
lead expert, компания Газинформсервис,
Complex Information Security Systems,
ну что, ребят, привет,
GIS.
Как у вас дела? Как настроение?
Замечательно.
Hi, good evening.
Не холодно?
Are you in a good mood?
Нет.
Do you feel okay?
Вчера было солнечно,
aren't you cold?
Сегодня что-то как не очень.
It was sunny yesterday. But today isn't that sunny.
Да.
But most importantly, there is no rain.
Мне, пожалуйста, кто
that's right, that's right.
Сетями?
Tell me more. Who of you uses social media? All of us. Which social media do you use?
ВКонтакте.
Of course, VK.
А, вот это запрещенное все, нет?
And the banned ones, the prohibited ones?
Конечно, нет. Все правильно.
Absolutely no. Oh, you're so law-abiding.
Вы все, так или иначе, в своей работе сталкиваетесь с инцидентами, с расследованием.
By the nature of your work, you face incidents and their consequences. And, of course, you must see lots of phishing emails and employees who click on the links from such phishing emails.
Говорят, что именно фишинговые письма — это самый распространенный вид
инструментов
для атаки. Это правда?
Да.
Is the most popular tool for attacks. Is it correct?
Я его смогу узнать?
That's right. What does an average phishing email look like? Can I recognize that? Am I able to?
Зависит от того, как это письмо составлено.
Answer. It depends on the way such an email is compiled.
Вообще есть несколько видов этого фишинга.
There are multiple types of phishing.
В основном это спам, то есть это
refer to the simplest one like spam.
Розыгрыш русское лото, там вы стали наследником там какого-нибудь принца из.
We receive an email that says that you can take part
по ссылке
in a prize draw and lottery.
Свой наследство и так далее. Это самый простой.
Claim that you are,
наверное,
a direct descendant of an African.
Но сейчас на самом деле тенденция
Royal personality, please claim your inheritance.
Письма становятся сложнее.
These are one of the types. Phishing becomes more and more complex. It becomes more and more challenging to recognize phishing emails. Therefore, there are quite a lot of incidents associated with phishing.
Well,
phishing is spelled differently, but translates as like normal phishing with an F.
Ну да, там просто пишется немножко по-другому, но.
But the spelling is different. PH versus F.
Вот.
Hackers are
выступаю, там, я,
the fishermen.
Наши слушатели,
who is the fish?
Коллеги,
that means me, you, our audience, and colleagues.
Письма,
those who received that email.
Да, у нас. Это может быть там.
And
там,
this email is a fishing hook.
We
звонки, keep referring to emails, but these can be calls, text messages,
видимо,
for a variety of notifications. What is the bait?
Хакер
the email body.
Плохое содержимое, плохую наживку. If they put
some
то есть,
malicious payload,
он просто его увидит, да, такая фигня, я не буду переходить. А если
users will not respond as they want them to.
Наживка, там текст.
If the bait is good enough, if the text is written properly, if they resort to social engineering,
то прям уже
approaches. My colleagues will dwell on that later.
Прям большая.
The probability of the fish.
Скажи, пожалуйста, какие фишинг вы видите?
Is higher. Please tell me, what kind of phishing emails do you see? What do they normally look like?
Сотрудника компании или Игоря как?
Is this question to
ей тоже приходит фишинг?
Me as a VK employee or as a son, because I have my mother and she keeps receiving phishing emails, so I
смотря кого ты интересуешь,
phishing her on daily basis. It depends.
Их рассказывал.
If these are regular scammers, there are plenty of them. There are thousands of them.
Базовые правила.
Then most likely, yes, you should observe some basic hygiene rules. Just get to read the email, just a little. Can I possibly have a grandfather in Africa? Or can I possibly win 5 million rubles tomorrow? This is how it works, because they may actually have such a grandfather who may win 5 million. Speaking of phishing attacks against companies, normally it's about targeted attacks prepared by experts. They take into account the linguistic properties of such attacks. We face this differently. Of course, as a service provider, we normally work with so-called professional phishing attempts. In this case, everything depends on the industry the company operates in, and so we provide our services accordingly. Дмитрий, Дима, please tell me, how do you deal with phishing emails at your company? Answer. Since we have phishing identification drills on a regular basis, that's the most effective tool for personnel not to fall for such phishing emails. If they fall for a phishing email just once, they will start taking information they receive with greater caution. It also takes a good anti-spam system, so you need to deflect most phishing emails as a line of defense. And then you have proper protection on workstations in case a user is not attentive enough. So there are three components to comprehensive security: drills for personnel, anti-spam, and anti-viral software. Some companies still prefer to save money, not purchase any antiviral software. So if I become an employee of a company, I can safely click on all links because you have anti-spam, anti-phishing, and antivirus. It's a false feeling of security and safety. Because the last line of defense is using common sense. Yes, you can click. But they say that, can you eat all mushrooms? Yes, you can eat all kinds of mushrooms, but several of them, you eat them only once in a lifetime. I suggest that you take a pause and try to see, what is this email all about? Does it comply with the basic identification features of a phishing email? Why do people fall for that? Is it so easy to do? Why do intruders make use of phishing attacks? It yields great benefits. Well, no, it's so simple. The Pareto rule works. A minimum effort yields the maximum result. It's a whole industry out there. It's a whole area. Segment of hacking. The tool set is so developed. There are so many articles out there on the forums. If you decide tomorrow to become a scammer, it would be easiest to go for phishing and become an expert, so to say. It requires the minimum effort and the minimum distance. It's the thinnest part of the wall separating hackers and internal systems of an organization. It's far easier to cross this gap through a user rather than its perimeter. It doesn't take any specific technical skills. Virtually, an average person can become a phishing attack scammer. It doesn't take that much of knowledge and equipment. In order to break into a system, it takes way more skills. So for phishing, the entry threshold is the lowest. Илья,
a
quick reminder. As information security systems evolve, they become stronger. While people feel kind of conservative, and the phishing techniques are still the same as they were 10 years ago. Psychology.
К использованию мессенджеров, к использованию социальных сетей.
Intruders are moving away from classic email phishing to using messages, social media, and all other available channels, including voice channels. We talked about phishing emails. They say I should think of the way this email is designed, what it looks like, what it says. And this will lead me to think that it's a phishing email. But if on social media, a friend of mine is texting me, can I be sure that it's really them? No. Unfortunately, it's one of the popular attack vectors. Scammers use an account of their friend, of their boss, or a fake account impersonating someone else, and they try and manipulate people. The first thought should be, are you being manipulated? Are you being forced to do something urgently, really quick, and provide some data? How should I act in such situation? Okay, I've got it on work emails, we should be sending right emails. If you receive a special email, you should alert your IT people. What happens? So you should send this, do the same thing. What do I do? It's the same thing. You submit this message to the VK support service, so you can report that message. There is support. The support is there for you. And if you call that person and ask them, why would they text you this way?
Yes,
for person-to-person communication, that can be a thing.
How
feasible is it to protect a company from such a threat? Because phishing emails, they really, really close to looking like a real email. Yes, you are quite right. They are trying to exploit our emotions.
Ну, первое вообще, что
how do you deal with emotions?
Для защиты от такого типа,
the first things companies do to protect from such attacks, they install protection systems,
почтовые,
network and email sandboxes.
Second, киберучения, как внутри компании, то есть
hold cyber security drills,
генерировать
training sessions, there is the systems that help you to generate such emails and then assess how many of the employees fell for that phishing attempt.
Базовое обучение, потому что когда человек знает, что такое,
то есть уже, наверное, basic induction training sessions
по безопасности уже сделаны.
Well, if people know that such a threat exists, that means that 50% of the security work is already done. I totally support Denis. I'm going to share an unpopular opinion from this stage as an IT security person. It depends on who wants to hack into your details. I'm pretty sure that if there are some serious people out there interested in you, if they want you to open up a phishing email, sooner or later, one day, you're going to open that phishing email. Even if you are a CEO of a company or the head of IT security, please describe an email that you will definitely open. Well, I live under the paradigm that they have no interest in me whatsoever. But what does it take for an email, phishing email to be opened by the IT security expert Грузаевский? Well, they are open, publicly available cases for phishing. It was not on email, but on social media.
То есть,
it's LinkedIn. I don't know whether it's prohibited.
Как бы не действует классическая через почту, здесь через социальные.
It's not classical. It's via social media.
Они есть.
А я правильно понимаю, что
IT security experts got infected?
Не хочешь ли ты поменять работу? Вот тебе
devices got infected.
Любого IT.
If they text you, do you want to get a new job? And what's the most thrilling thing for IT people?
Берет психологию.
A new job. Psychology always works.
Миллионов лотерею для IT-шника.
For a regular person, it's about winning 5 million rubles. For an IT specialist, it's about getting a great job offer tomorrow. Can you possibly protect the company in such conditions?
So,
давайте говорить честно, что 100% защиты никогда не
wins,
то есть тот
inheritance, a new job, how can you get protected? There is never 100% protection. There are several scenarios which can be implemented by scammers, and that will lead to certain consequences. Our job as IT people, IT security people, is to make the implementation of such scenarios as hard as possible and reduce the critical critical nature, criticality of such
hacks.
You can hack into any system,
but
it's about how critical it is. If a minor service goes down, which is not largely used in a company, it's not critical. Yes, it's not pleasant.
Как у вас в городе, то, что на стендофе происходит, тогда, конечно же, это все намного
критично.
Подходы в защите. Поэтому,
a SCADA system. Then it's an absolutely different thing. So you need to do your best to reduce the probability of such a hack. And if it still happens, the consequences should be bearable, tolerable for the company. How do you reduce that possibility?
As I mentioned,
reducing the such exposure can be made by proper configuration of your IT systems, training, and maintenance of IT security systems. That is,
делать правильные навыки,
конечно же, уделять максимум внимания
фактору, потому что,
and all settings and configurations should be in order. Machines don't make mistakes. While those humans who configure these machines, they
аудиты, когда все это в целом
error-prone.
И когда к системе информационной безопасности относится как
when you treat information security system as a process which is being provided on a continuous basis, which comes from the past, happens in the present, and continues in the future, then the risk will be minimized. Okay, let's imagine that I'm an average person, which I am, but let's suppose that I don't work in an information security company. Let's suppose that I don't work in a large company that has a good understanding of what information security is about, does know what phishing emails are. Me personally, can I do at least something for myself to protect myself from phishing attacks? Myself, my family, my friends, my company, my data, my funds, my money. Do I stand any chances? Of course, you do stand a lot of chances, like any other person present here today. First of all, you need to be attentive. You need to realize the consequences that may follow in the event of a successful attack. You may lose access to your accounts, you may lose funds in your bank account. Your social media account may be taken over. If you fear that,
if you понять, что происходит.
Take a pause, think again.
Скажем так, второй,
try to understand what is actually going on. The second piece of advice I can come up with for regular users who don't work in the information security field.
Get
spend some money, don't be greedy on antiviral software. Antiviral software normally includes anti-phishing systems. Even if you make a mistake, the system will help you out. And most importantly, stay attentive
and
take with great caution what is going on the internet. Do not share your personal details and data. Do not use links you don't know. Be aware of the links you're following. Protesters use social engineering techniques to get their hands on your money.
Но в целом,
and then everything is going to be fine. Do you agree with this piece of advice? I do agree.
При коммуникациях,
you need to develop a habit.
When you неожиданные коммуникации, да, неважно,
have some communication. You need to detect
коммуникации неожиданные просьбы денег,
unexpected communication.
Который не писал, нет,
an old friend,
неожиданно
you've not been,
есть провалы, да, должно настораживать, и
been in touch with for several years, is texting you, asking for money,
действительно ли это запрос,
take a pause, that's point A and point B,
канал коммуникаций.
Check that this is a real thing. Use a different communication channel. Give them a phone call. Ask them if they actually wrote that text message.
And
ask them if it's that urgent. The same works for business. If you received an urgent email or message from a colleague or your boss, it's easy to call them back and use different channel to verify whether it's actually true. Do you have any kids? Yes, yes. And some of you has mothers, fathers, grandmothers and grandfathers, right? Please tell me the following.
С детьми, родственниками.
Do you often organize drills, training sessions?
Делитесь своим опытом.
with your friends and their kids and their family to share some experience of yours? Probably not. Until a fraudster approached my grandmother, she received a phone call. They told her that I got in a car crash, and they told her that a person will show up to pick up the money.
So
the idea is to exert some psychological pressure to convince a person to give the money away to a person they don't know. When they are under stress, they don't know what to do. And she says, yes. And she gives out the money. Then she calls me back. I was sleeping in the middle of the night. Are you in a car crash? No, I'm not. I'm in my bed at home. So she fell for that. That was an unpleasant case. It was after that I organized a certain training session, a drill for my friends and family. They may call you. They even called me, impersonating a bank employee. They called me via WhatsApp. The user profile picture is the logo of the Ministry of Internal Affairs of Russia. And they impersonate a major of police.
Well,
will they come for me? Will they arrest me? Am I doing something wrong? They call you back. I know that you are fraudsters, and you just tell them that you know who they are, and you block them. And you? Do you do some awareness raising with your friends and family? That's a good point. So our mothers and grandmothers is the target audience for such scammers, because for a person born in the Soviet Union, the word loan or credit is a trigger. The IT people know this hard rule. Everything which is not allowed is prohibited. I tell my mother, you have this phone book, you have a limited set of numbers of people you talk to, and anything else should not bother you at all. Therefore, it's the simplest way. The more you talk to a person, the more you communicate with a fraudster, the more you are influenced by this fraudland activity.
Илья, как ты работаешь с окружающими?
Илья, how do you deal with your friends and family? Do you organize any training sessions?
Старшим членам семьи проводить лекции периодически.
I have to deliver lectures to the oldest and to the youngest members of my family, because the elders, they normally have more respect for human-to-human communication and state bodies. They have more respect for state bodies. When scammers impersonate a state authority official, something clicks in their brain, a switch works, and they fall for that.
Well,
kids tend to trust adults. Therefore, when an adult approaches them, they tend to trust them. Unfortunately, we have to explain it to them, that you have to double-check everything in this world. Thank you, Dima, Dmitry. Well, it's pretty simple. With the elder generations, if they receive some calls, they say, okay, go talk to my son. And this is how all communication ends. There are plenty of scams out there. These have nothing to do with the internet. People physically show up at your door and tell you, okay, we want to have your plastic windows replaced. We're going to replace your gas.
С папой, с мамой пообщайтесь, поэтому научены и все
проконтролируем. So the kids are taught not to trust anyone and refer
any conversation attempts to the adults.
Let's get back to work. The four of you boasted that you do hold to organize drills for personnel. How do you normally schedule such training sessions? What does a training drill look like in terms of anti-phishing? The drill is pretty boring. We purchased in February a service. It's a special service. We installed it inside our network, and then we started sending out emails. Who should receive and who shouldn't? That part of the work was pretty boring. But what followed that was the results and the interpretation of such results.
Мнение сотрудников о киберучениях.
And the feedback of employees on that cybersecurity drill. My co-host is kindly waiting for the floor. My opponent, Сергей Есенин, has all his poems like phishing emails. Well, that's a joke. But seriously speaking, thank you for enlightening me. I used to think that phishing is actually fishing in a pond or in a river for fish. Thank you, Vladimir Vladimirovich Maikovsky. I hope you will not receive any kind of phishing emails with malicious intentions and malware attached from your fans. We have a pretty wide audience.
Топ признаков, по которым мы можем
отличить
фишинговое письмо от нефишингового. Давайте
назовем characteristics of indicators to tell a phishing email, a phishing message from a normal message.
Чтобы признаки не совпадали.
So, I address each of you. Please state your top list, but please do not repeat yourselves. It's not very obvious. When you receive a business email, it's not in line with your business, your scope of work, with your job description. Second, targeted phishing, which is aimed at specific users in a company. You receive a message that is from a very strange person you never interact with. Okay, by the nature of my work, there is a department I normally never engage in any email communication with it. It would be weird. And the third indicator is the versatile, most versatile. You receive an email outside of the regular 9-6 business hours. Oh, it can be 8-9. But if you receive an email at 2 a.m., at 3 a.m., something must be going wrong.
Probably
it is an email from a crazy PR specialist shortly before an important event. It's a PR person, that's clear. Shortly before an important event, PR people will be communicating extensively. But the head of a department will never ever send emails at 2 a.m., at 3 a.m.
Хорошо, я поняла. Мы
so I leave other simpler indicators for my colleagues.
Не соответствует теме нашей работы.
Be cautious about emails that are not in line with your job description, emails received outside of regular business hours, and emails from people you normally don't have to talk to by the nature of your work.
Все плохие
Let's make the life simpler for my
что-то сделать.
Colleagues. So, all phishing emails would normally require you to do something. Call someone, change something, make something, send something, do something. And good people just send the emails, and you have nothing to do with them.
Манипулирование, да,
срочность. You will be likely to be manipulated. It will say that it's urgent. Check for spelling mistakes in names, last names, incorrect words, poor punctuation, like incorrect comma placement, and others are urgency and authority. And Dennis, I have nothing to say. I will support everyone else. You will support everyone else.
Ну что же, если вам приходит письмо в 3 часа ночи,
so different. If you receive an email at 2 a.m. or 5 a.m. from John Doe, who is claiming they are your director and they want you to click a link and download an attached file because they wanted to fire you yesterday, be advised it is likely to be a phishing email. You don't have to do anything about that. And if you have a chance, forward this email to the Information Security Department. They will do the job and analyze it. Денис Кувшинов, head of Cybersecurity Threat Analysis Department with Positive Technologies. Илья Борисов, head of Department of Methodology for Information Security of VK Social Media. Игорь Заевский, head of JSOC of Ростелекомсор. Газинформсервис, head of Complex Comprehensive information security systems. Thank you.
Фишинговое письмо стали
I hope that we at least one phishing email further away from getting into the hands of scammers. Thank you so much.